all present here. We feel ecstatic to welcome our chief guest, Dr. Vinu Thomas, Director Sir Dr. K.V. Thomas, Dean and Senior Principal Dr. Leelama Thomas, Principal Mrs. Annie Rita Joseph, level teachers, parents, and of course, our startling students to this grand occasion.
Words are rose petals that are sprinkled with fragrance to invite one and all with warm greetings. Yes, we are all joined together as a family to divulge the edition of another momentous accomplishment in the history of Campion School. We are here to unveil the curtains of RESILIENCIA, our 32nd annual day celebrations. I, Azam.
And I, Swati, salute you all on behalf of the entire Campion family. Not merely words, but our heartfelt feelings filled with emotions add flavor to welcoming you all. Education is not only learning from the book, but learning beyond books. School enfolds a child's academic caliber, but it does not stop there. Values weave the very texture of life in Campion culture. Gentleness, helping hands, empathy, compassion, and loving hearts are what you can see in different activities and performances. Service is not an option, but an obligation. In Campion, we are seated with these values of truth, beauty, and love.
Prayer is the raising of one's mind and heart to God, or the requesting of good things from God. It is better in prayer to have a heart without words than words without heart. Prayer is when you talk to God. Meditation is when you listen to God. Let us seek the Almighty's blessings with a prayer song by the school choir. Over to the school choir for the musical ecstasy.
I now invite the school choir for the Campion anthem, followed by the welcome song.
Disciples of Redmond Campion, courage and truth. It's a fake man campion. We campions welcome you all. We welcome you each warmly. We greet you with joy and pride. We campions welcome you all.
Dance is the pulse, the heartbeat, the breathing. It's the rhythm of your life. It's the expression in time and movement, in happiness, joy, sadness, and envy. Dance is literature, painting, and poetry. Dance is the divine form of art. We have our exuberant dancers to mesmerize you with their performance. Thank you.
That was a spectacular show put up. Now we request all the dignitaries to please occupy their seats on the dais. He is an extraordinary person, a prophecy of distinctness, an excellent educationist, a profound scholar, and an inspiration for many. He is none other than our renowned chief guest of the day, Dr. Vinu Thomas. I humbly request our chief guest to please occupy the seat on the dais.
He is a distinguished educationist, a motivational speaker, prudent in making judgments. His guidance has always led us to success in all our endeavors. Yes, he's none other than our director, sir, Dr. K.V. Thomas.
She is an educationist, a statue of knowledge and experience, a source of inspiration and support. She is none other than our dear Madam, Dean and Senior Principal, Dr. Lilama Thomas.
She is an idol of knowledge, a mentor and a guide, a support in all our endeavors. She is our Principal, Mrs. Annie Rita Joseph.
As fair as the breeze, as wondrous as the sea, enchanting to the heart, a warm welcome would be. Now I call upon Kumari Roseanne Sober to drizzle the sweet aroma of happiness through the words of welcome to the gathering.
A smile that radiates love to all the people around makes everyone happy. When hearts are free from gloom, no wonder smiles are in full bloom. Today, with heart full of love and happiness, I hereby spell out words of welcome to this August gathering. I deem it a great pleasure and privilege to welcome our honorable chief guest for the day, Dr. Vinu Thomas, principal of Government Engineering College, Chertala. Our director, sir, Dr. K.V. Thomas, Madam Dean and Senior Principal, Dr. Lilama Thomas, Principal, Mrs. Annie Rita Joseph, parents, teachers, and all my dear fellow Campions, to RESILIENCIA, the 32nd Campion Day celebrations. The true grandeur of humanity is in moral elevation, continuous, enlightened, and decorated by the intellect of man. Yes, today we have one such eminent personality amongst us. On this auspicious occasion, we feel deeply elevated to take note of the presence of our chief guest, who is renowned in his profession. Sir, your hard work and commitment in the field of education supplement the same. We extend a warm welcome to our chief guest of the day, Dr. Vinu Thomas. A true artist is not one who is inspired, but rather one who inspires others. You are a person who embraces challenges, believe in continuous effort. Indeed, your work ethics is a true rumination that invigorates everyone to achieve the pinnacle. Your around-the-clock concern, guidance, and support proves that you're an extraordinary leader. We extend the genial welcome to our dear director, sir, Dr. K.V. Thomas. The fragrance of flowers spread only in the direction of the wind, but the goodness of a person spreads in all directions. With great splendor and joy, we extend a hearty welcome to our dear Madam, Dean and Senior Principal, Dr. Lilama Thomas, in whose presence a million incomplete souls feel complete. We welcome you, ma'am. The best evidence of merit is the corporal recognition of it, whenever and wherever it may be found. We extend a hearty welcome to our dear principal, Mrs. Annie Rita Joseph, who is a true inspiration for the students. We welcome you, ma'am. There is no love, no friendship like that of the parent for their child. With heartfelt gratitude, we welcome our dear moms and dads. You showed us the world and laid the path. Your presence here is highly esteemed. We cherish your love in all our actions. We extend a pleasant welcome to each and every one of you. Welcome, dear parents. The duties of a teacher are neither few nor small, but they elevate the mind and give energy to the character. You are our real-life miners and role models who create enticing environments, ennobling and igniting our minds to explore the unknown. It is our proud privilege to welcome you, our dear teachers. Life is not about expecting, hoping, and wishing. It's about doing, being, and becoming. We owe much to the members of the non-teaching faculty. Undoubtedly, you have become an asset for us. We cherish your meaningful accompaniment in our growth. You stand by us every day and coordinate everything on the home front. We wholeheartedly welcome you all. Today is your day. Start fresh. Be proud. Don't be stressed. Do your best and forget the rest. We put our hearts together to welcome the treasures of Campion. You are the true performers and you make the event colorful. Let this be a memorable and marvelous day, leaving in everyone's heart an indelible mark in your memory. A hearty welcome to the twinkling stars of Campion School. The bird which dares to fall is the bird which learns to fly. Once again, I welcome this August gathering. Welcome.
Thank you, Roseanne, for embracing the audience with the words of warmth. A man with perfection in all his actions, ever ready to walk that extra mile to achieve greater dreams for the future of the young minds. Firm and disciplined but gentle at heart, he is none other than our dear director, sir, Dr. K.V. Thomas. So, with reverence, I request our director, sir, to address the gathering.
The chief guest of today's function, Dr. Vinay Thomas, Principal, Government Engineering College, Chertley. The Dean and Senior Principal of the Institution, Dr. Leelama Thomas, the Principal of the School, and Mrs. Annie Rita, my dear teachers, parents, some parents who have come here for the function, and parents beyond this offline program, and the students of the school, Campions, my dear Campions. I really feel, I don't know what to say. I miss this kind of meeting many a time. And I longed for this kind of meeting. So many months, we were not meeting each other like this. We didn't feel each other together for some time, and we missed all of you, this kind of occasions where we could see the pulse of the young people, young students, showing forth their vitality and life on the stage and beyond the stage. Today, we are trying to remember Campion Day. Campion Day was in a grand level we used to conduct so many years, maybe 32 years. 32 years is not a short period for an institution. Through these years, we have seen the growth of children who passed by the gates of the institution, found their lives in different parts of the world. And I feel really proud that we could make and shape the destiny of so many people in the world meaningfully and effectively. So on this day, when I make myself stand before you to make the keynote address, I feel like talking about what is the purpose of this kind of meetings, this kind of celebrations. Any organization, any nation, any family all over the world celebrate their annual day different forms. Annual days recall, make us remember what happened in the past so that we experience the original experience of the founders of the institution. See, for example, when we celebrate the Independence Day on the 15th of August, we remember what happened on the 15th of midnight of the 15th of August in 1947. The spirit with which India became independent. We absorb that spirit and then we renew ourselves and become better Indians. The same way when we celebrate Republic Day of our country. Same thing happens when we celebrate this kind of programs. We try to go back to the origin of the institution. What is the vision of this institution? In English language, there is a way of saying, using when prefix, that is called, RE. So retreat, revise, research, rewind, and all these expressions of using this prefix RE makes us all understand we are going back. The army is a retreat. We go back and revise our lessons, go back, and we rethink what should be done. We rediscover new things. So the scientists and all these technologies, they revise and research and find out new things. So when we this kind of programs, what happens is that we go back to the origin of the organization or a nation or anything. In this institution, we go back the origin of our institution, the spirit of the institution. From this spirit, we have our mission to the world. That is what happened all these 32 years. The spirit we have absorbed from Campion, Edmund Campion. You can listen about him in the panegyric or the in praise of Edmund Campion by Master Madhav R. Shankar later. You'll find how a significant person he was. We try to listen to that speech, try to get back to the spirit of Campion, who is our captain, who is molding our mind and spirit and body so that we become truly champions. That is what we intended to do on programs like this. Get back and renew yourself. Become new persons. Different person from when you came. So that's why Evelyn Waugh, I quote from Evelyn Waugh, the biographer of Edmund Campion, an English novelist, he said, "The voice of Campion comes across the centuries as he were walking at our side." So if you absorb Campion in our mind, we feel that he is walking with you Walking by, I feel His presence. Every day, I feel His presence nearby. When I come to the school, when I think of the school, the spirit I have absorbed from Him. He was a man deeply rooted in faith. He had a tremendous scholarship, ability, brilliance of mind. He sacrificed everything, power, position, name, all for what he thought was his aim, the glory of God, his faith in God. That is why he is standing significant. That is why Evelyn says, the voice of Campion comes across us through the centuries as if he were walking at our side. His life was so simple, perfectly true, a perfectly true story of heroism and holiness. That is what Campion is. So we are getting back to him and get his spirit and go forward. So let us try to do that. Wish you all the best. Thank you for coming for this meeting, especially the parents and the teachers. And we'll do our best in the coming days to make our life more meaningful, more understanding, and so on. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. The imprints made by you will be cherished in our minds forever. Good teachers give their students roots and wings, roots to know where home is, wings to fly and exercise what is being taught. Thus, we are given confidence to build our future. Today, Campion is stepping into 32 years of its existence, serving the society in the footsteps of Edmund Campion, our founder in the field of education to the best of its caliber. So I invite Master Madhav Ashankar to deliver the panegyric on Edmund Campion.
A warm and a pleasant morning to one and all present here. Today I, Madhav Ashankar, am here to deliver a panegyric on Sir Edmund Campion. On December 1st, 1581, a man of 41 years old was tortured and hanged at Tyburn in London. He was none other than our captain, Edmund Campion. He was a scholar, hero, and a martyr. His life exemplifies all that is fine and appealing in human beings. His brilliance of mind, gentleness of person, and his unfaltering loyalty to faith led to his torture and death. Edmund Campion was born in 1540 at London. He received a scholarship from St. John's College at the age of 15. He became a fellow when he was only 17. Yet, his brilliance was admired by many leading persons at that time, like the Earl of Leicester, Robert Cecil, and even Queen Elizabeth. He attracted around him a group of pupils over whom he exerted an effortless and comprehensive influence. They crowded to his lectures, imitated his habits of speech and mannerisms. Later, Campion took the oath of supremacy, acknowledging Queen Elizabeth, the head of the church in England, and became an Anglican deacon in 1564. In 1569, he went to Ireland, where he studied further and returned to Catholicism. Forced to flee from the persecutions unleashed on Catholics by the Queen, he went to France, where he learned more about religion. Finally, in 1580, he came back to England. After that, he was captured and imprisoned in the Tower of London when he refused to give up his faith in religion. Later, he was hanged at Tyburn in London on December 1st, 1581. His determination till his last breath is still admired by many of us. In spite of his personal outstanding brilliance and eternal prowess, Campion could sacrifice anything in this world. The spirit of Campion should inspire us. He was a man deeply rooted in faith in God. He was a man who understood the heart and soul of religion. Indeed, he was one of the greatest scholars at that time. Therefore, we all must replicate his brilliance of mind and loyalty. So, let us Campions take a pledge today that we will follow Campion, our captain, in his footsteps wherever we are. Thank you.
Thank you, Mother. Admiration of a genius makes one aspire for excellence in life that creates the harvest so abundant. Examples move the world more than doctrine. We take immense pleasure to recognize the valued presence of our chief guest of the day, Dr. Vinu Thomas. Now I call upon Kumari Bhavya Prashant to introduce the chief guest of the day.
A teacher affects eternity. He can never tell where his influence stops. Good morning, everyone. I'm exceedingly delighted and honored to introduce our Reverend Chief Guest of the Day, Dr. Vinu Thomas. Dr. Vinu Thomas is a committed teacher, an intellectual, and a didact. After graduating in Electronics and Communications Engineering from Mar Athanasius College of Engineering, Kodamangalam, he completed his Master's in Electronics and secured first rank and gold medal from the Department of Electronics, CUSAT. Further, he obtained his doctorate degree in Microwave Tomography from the same university. Apart from his academic excellence, Dr. Vinu Thomas is also an accomplished teacher. He served the College of Engineering, Chetala, IHRD, as an associate professor, principal in charge, and principal. He assumed various roles while working at the Government Model Engineering College, Chetala, where he served as an associate professor, academic in charge, and principal. Dr. Vinu Thomas is currently the principal of Government Model Engineering College, Chetala. We feel elated to have such an exemplary genius among us today. Sir, we wholeheartedly welcome you to the 32nd Campion Day celebrations. Thank you.
Thank you, Bhavya. Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. Let us wish this light of education takes over the darkness of difference, injustice, and violence in the world and guide us towards progress, equality, and freedom. Now we request our chief guest, Dr. Vinu Thomas, to light the lamp and have an auspicious beginning to this much awaited day.
Shine.
Thank you, sir. We keep moving forward, opening new doors and doing new things because we are curious, and curiosity keeps leading us down new paths. May I now request our chief guest of the day to please address the gathering.
So, respected director, Dr. K.V. Thomas, Dean and Senior Principal, Dr. Leenama Thomas, the Principal of the school, Srimati Ani Rita, dear faculty members, and dear Campions. Let me thank you at the outset for this privilege. So I must confess that without a prepared text, I tend to speak longer. So in order to keep this very crisp, I have a prepared text with me, so I'll go through the prepared text and deviate from the text if required. I'm sure all Campions would have been eagerly waiting forward to this day. When they get to interact with their friends, during your arts festival, during your annual festival that you have appropriately named as Resiliencia. In fact, this is a festival of resilience. I understand that Resiliencia is probably Latin for resilience. So, in fact, we have been going through unprecedented times. The last 2 years, you would have probably have had online classes where you could have met your friends through the internet. But nothing beats meeting your friends in person, right? So friends form an important cog of one's support system. You probably share with your friends much more than with your parents or with your teachers. I say this from my life experiences as a student, as a parent, and as a faculty. Therefore, having good friends is important in one's life. Let me emphasize this again. We are talking about good friends. So I was very impressed by the school choir who rendered excellent songs and by the dance team that rendered a very excellent dance on stage. I saw a few faculty members, in particular one lady faculty member who was watching the program with folded hands. She was actually praying. I believe that she was actually praying when some of her students were delivering their speeches. So I'm really impressed, ma'am. You have an excellent team of faculty over here. You consider the students as no less than their own children. I was looking through your website yesterday and I found that Campion School and Government Model Engineering College Trikakra, the college where I work right now is Government College of Engineering Chertala. So I spent my lion's share of my career as a faculty in various cadres at Government Model Engineering Trikakra from 1995 onwards. And as principal during the period 2018-21, Campion School and Government Model Engineering College Trikakara were established in 1989. Model Engineering College started its functioning from a campus in Edappally, so things are uncannily similar there. I have had many students at Government Model Engineering College whom I have taught, who have done their schooling from Campion School. As I was mentioning to Dr. Leelama, I recollect two of my very favorite students, Lakshmi Jayakumar, who graduated from our college in 2017, and Ms. Rhea Jackson and her sister also, who studied from this school. I now work at another college, albeit a much smaller one, at College of Engineering Chertala, since the month of October 2021, which is under the same management. I'm very proud of my students at wherever I have taught, at Government Model Engineering College and also at College of Engineering Chertala. And I'm attached to all of them as your teachers are. You might have heard that Model Engineering College is one of the leading colleges in Kerala. Let me just say that College of Engineering Chertala is on the way there, though we have a lot of catching up to do in terms of academic results and campus recruitments. Now I was racking my brains about what I should speak about today. I finally decided that I will talk about my present students. In particular, about one student who I was fortunate to have got acquainted in the past 2 months. So as I understand, this program is being aired live on YouTube, right, ma'am? So therefore, I will have to be careful not to take your name here. Anyway, my student was featured in a program that was aired on Malavil Manorama. Some of you might have watched the channel. About a year back, the program is called Udan Panam. I don't know whether you have seen that program. But I still think it is prudent not to mention my dear student's name here. Her father had passed away when she was a child. Her mother works as a housekeeping staff at a private hospital. She has a younger sister who is at school. And their family was fortunate to have her father's younger brother to support them when they were young. Later, a few years back, he too passed away in the most unfortunate circumstances. And her late uncle's family, including his wife and two children, also stay with them in their two-room house, which means there are a few more mouths to feed. Now you can try to picture my student. At least some of you might get the impression of a sad adolescent who is weighed down by her circumstances. I will say that you could not be more wrong. She has an infectious smile at all times and is one of the most positive persons that I have ever met. And all our faculty also concur with this. She bakes the most exquisite cakes. And I understand that she has got a reasonable clientele for her cakes. This additional income supplements her family's savings and finances her studies and also that of her sisters and her cousins. She is doing reasonably well given her circumstances in her studies. I'm very positive about her graduating this year and landing up a job from the campus. And all of us at our college are rooting for her to do this. I put it this way, I have learned more lessons in life from her than what she has learned from me. I have no doubt that Campion School attracts very good students. Now, at the cost of making a generalization, I feel that you would not have had to strive for day-to-day survival, unlike my student. You are very lucky to have a great support system around you, loving parents, an excellent school with great teachers, and beautiful infrastructure, very good or at least reasonably good financial background, etc. Therefore, consider yourself lucky that as students, all you need to do is study and perform well and be a good citizen. Your support system will take care of everything. I understand that we have 11 standard students here. So after 2 years of study, they would probably be entering a college of their own choice. They will be choosing a study of a stream of their own choice. So let me address those 11th and 12th standard students also. So these are your make or break years, do your best, as your efforts will decide what you will do with the rest of your lives. There is no substitute for hard work, as Edison once famously said. Don't stop when it hurts. Stop only when you are done. The pain that you feel today is a strength that you will feel tomorrow. The only person that you are destined to become is the person that you decide to be. So stay positive always. Always look at the bright side of life, like my student does. So thank you all. God bless you all. Have a great day, Campions.
Thank you, sir, for your inspiring words. To write is human, to edit is divine. Stephen King. We are really proud and enthusiastic to acclaim that we are ready with our new edition of our e-newsletter, Brag, which will surely unfold the most unforgettable and precious moments of our school. Our sweet and syrupy memories on each pinnacle of schooling are bordered as an evernote, page by page, into static as a publication. Now we request our chief guest, Dr. Vinu Thomas, to release the e-newsletter, and to our beloved Madam Dean and Senior Principal, Dr. Lilama Thomas, to accept the same. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Success is work. Success is opportunity. Success is believing you can. Success is sweet, and its secret is sweat. Now it's time we give due recognition to the aptitude and acumen of our brimming students, future leaders of our society. It's time for the prize distribution ceremony, so I cordially invite our chief guest to give away the prizes.
A glorious day to all. Everyone has a will to win, but very few have the will to prepare to win. Today we have before us a group, a bunch of achievers, toppers. And why are they here today? Because they did not stammer when they found challenges. They were ready to embrace the challenges and gave it all that they had to make sure they saw the light of success. So with great pride and honor, I invite the chief guest of the day, Dr. Vinu Thomas, to award the prize winners. The award in memory of Father K.V. George, SDB, given to the topper in English, Shweta Thomas. The award in memory of late Mrs. Kuchitresia, given to the toppers of various subjects. Topper in mathematics, Uttara Menon. And Arjun Shaji Vettiyattil. In the absence of Uttara Menon, her parents are here to collect the prize.
Topper in physics, Arjun Shaji Vettiyattil. Topper in chemistry, P. Alexandra Susan. Topper in biology, P. Alexandra Susan. Topper in computer science, Iron Robbie. Topper in informatic practices, backed by Sharon and George. And Rohini Pradeep. In their absence, their parents will collect the prizes. Topper in economics, Uttara Menon. Topper in accountancy, Uttara Menon. Topper in business studies, Uttara Menon. The award in memory of late Mr. Epen Varghese for the students who secured the highest percentage marks in Campion School in secondary school certificate examination by CBSE in 2021, Commerce Stream goes to Uttara Menon. Science Stream, P. Alexandra Susan. Students who secured A1 in all subjects in SSCE 2021, Science Stream, P. Alexandra Susan, Arjun Shaji Vettiyattil, Iron Robbie. Commerce Stream, Uttara Menon and Anjana Babu. Thank you, sir. Now I request the director of Campion School, Dr. K.V. Thomas, to award the winners. Secondary School Examination 2021, School Topper, Midun Biju Kumar. Second School Topper, Anne Elise Joseph. And Vadakkat Tarang. Please give a great hand to Anne Elise Joseph. Third topper, Madhav R. Shankar and S.M. Ashwant. The toppers of various subjects, English backed by 2, Gauri M. Krishna and P. Anthony Vimal Benito. Hindi, Vadakkat Tarang. Malayalam, Midun Biju Kumar. Mathematics, Vadakkat Tarang. Science, Midun Biju Kumar. Social Science, 5 in number, and Elise Joseph. Abel K. Jomi, Neha Elizabeth Nobi, Madhav R. Shankar, Mridul Martin. Computer applications, Savio Chako Savior. Painting, Ryan Vinod Palathingal. Now, I humbly request our Dean and Senior Principal, Dr. Leelamma Thomas, to award the students who secured A1 in all subjects. Angelo Ulahanan, Midun Biju Kumar, Swati Krishna KU, Farasat Ahmad TS, Madhav R. Shankar, Abel K. Jomi, V. Kiruba, Abhinav S. Nair, Anjali Dilip K, Rehan George Matthew, Anne Elise Joseph, Ashwin A. Thank you, ma'am. Now I would like to request our principal, Mrs. Annie Rita Joseph, to give away the prizes. Mridul Martin, Shahana Yasmin, P. Anthony Vimal Benito, Neha Elizabeth Nobi, Kaustub B. Kamat, D. Aksa Rachel, Lakshmi Priya Radish, Vadakat Tarang, Ivan Anthony Philip, S.M. Ashwant, Navita K.P., Kester Xavier. Thank you, Miss. Congratulations and all the very best to the winners.
Thank you, sir. Thankfulness is the beginning of gratitude. Gratitude is a completion of thankfulness. May I now request our director, sir, Dr. K.V. Thomas, to hand over the memento to our chief guest as a token of our love and acknowledgement.
Thank you, sir. If we are thankful for everything the way God tells us to be, what a wonderful change in our living we would be able to see. Now I request Master Michelle Godwin to propose the vote of thanks.
Gratitude makes sense of our past, brings peace for today, and creates a vision for tomorrow. Now, it's time to say a big thanks to all the great hearts. Honorable chief guest for the day, respected director, sir, a madam, dean, and senior principal, principal, teachers, parents, and my dear fellow campions. It is my privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this auspicious occasion. Thanksgiving has wings, and it goes where it must go. And our prayers knows much more about it than we do. First and foremost, we raise our hearts in gratitude and thank the Lord Almighty for blessing us with this wonderful day. His unfailing love keeps us march forward towards a better tomorrow. Leaders are not born, they are made. I would like to take this opportunity to place on record a hearty thanks to our chief guest, Dr. Vinu Thomas, for presiding over this colorful festivity. We are greatly encouraged and immensely benefited by your inspiring address. Thank you, sir. Thank you is a small word. Your guidance helps us achieve the best. On this auspicious occasion, we acknowledge the valuable presence of our director, sir, Dr. K.V. Thomas, who has been the pillar of strength in all our endeavors. Thank you, sir. God gave me the eyes, but you showed me the skies. A heartfelt thanks to our dear madam, Dean and Senior Principal, Dr. Leela M. Thomas. It is your vision and leadership that has made everything possible in this campus. I thank you, ma'am. Gratitude inspires happiness and carries divine influence. We feel proud to spell out the words of thanks and gratitude to our principal, Mrs. Annie Rita Joseph, who helps us and guides us in all our endeavors. Thank you, miss. Parents are the stars that guide us. With love and care, they hide us. Dear parents, you have a very special place in our thoughts. We thank you, dear parents, for the love and support that you have given us. You help us find our best. I thank you, parents. Teachers guided us when we were confused. They supported us when we were weak. They motivated us, inspired us, and edified us all through. With great veneration, I thank all our dear teachers who made this day a very special one by bringing out the best in us. We also acknowledge the efforts and endeavors taken by them in making us who we are today. Thank you, teachers. If niceness is your way, then happiness can never be far away. I thank all our non-teaching staff and all the people who have worked for technical arrangements, stage setup, photographs, sound and light, who added carnival to this event. I thank you all. The kernel of the fruit is always tasted last, and we opine last will be the best ever. I thank all the participants for your energetic and enthusiastic participation. Your every action on the stage made us spellbound. The future belongs to the competent. So get going, be better, and be the best. Once again, thanking you all for your valuable presence. Thank you.
Thank you, Michelle. Endings are not unpleasant things. They just mean that something else is about to begin. And there are many things that don't really end. They just begin again in a new way. Challenges are ahead. Nurturers are behind, tending to create a beautiful garden where buds and blossoms bloom, diffusing their sweet fragrance far and wide.
With this, we have come to the end of the inaugural ceremony of the annual day, marking it open for the students to ignite their talents and passions. So let's kickstart the saga of events. All the best to all the participants. This is me, Swati.
And me, Azam, signing off. Thank you.
Edmund Campion, the well-known scholar, orator, and educationalist, was a person with an unwavering faith in God, who sacrificed his life for the values he believed in. Born in 1540 and going through an eventful journey of life, he died in 1581. In remembrance to the services he rendered, the city of Kochi on the 9th of June 1989 witnessed the birth of a new institution, the Campion School. The Campion School functions under the Campion Trust, which aims to spread the light of knowledge through a responsible set of citizens who have been brought up and nurtured through value-based education.
Integrity, noetic, discipline, optimistic. This makes Campion Kinderworld.
Hi, I am mother of Maha Padma. Campion Kinderworld provided her with all the necessary education. I would say Manha was not good at her fine motor skills initially, but with the proper guidance of the teachers and the new methods of learning made her so much of improvements in her academics as well as co-curricular activities. I would like to thank Campion Kinderworld for your enormous support. Thank you.
Campion Kinderworld is a brand, a place where kids enjoy learning and playing.
I am Arun, father of Ashwin and Aishwarya, who have just completed their LKG from Campion Kinderworld. I would like to take this opportunity to thank all the teachers of Campion Kinderworld who have helped in conducting the online sessions effectively. They have helped to inculcate good learning skills in our kids. I thank you very much.
Kinderworld provides the best learning environment with modern infrastructure and facilities for your child. Our curriculum is designed with international holistic standard of education. During this pandemic situation, Kinderworld online classes were very productive and informative. Activity-based learning, lots of group activities, personal caring, well-trained teachers, new methods of teaching, extracurricular activities like dance, music, arts, crafts, etc.
Dance representation of how the phoenix bird rises from the ashes, which it symbolizes the human nature overcoming the difficulties for a better future. Let's enjoy.
Should I ask myself in the water? Hear my loyal, brave and true. Cold is the morning, warm is the tree. Chasing the answers until I can sleep. Will I be stronger or will I be weak when you're not with me? Who am I without my armor? Standing in my father's shoes. All I know is that it's harder to be loyal, brave, and true.
Anything and everything that we find in nature encompasses the answers to all life questions. What may appear simple and light can grant us nothing less than heavenly bliss. They radiate hope, joy, harmony, potentiality, and all that we aspire in new beginning. Today, we, the students of Class 1, would like to present before you a manifestation of our vibrant future. Thank you.
Thank you.
the strength of perseverance. There's a seed inside of every tree and the tree inside of every seed. This is a beautiful story of a tiny seed that battles for survival with all the odds of nature. To bloom into a blossoming plant, let's witness this adventurous journey of the tiny seed through a scintillating musical.
Thank you.
the cultural roots of a particular group of people. It keeps the culture of people alive by sharing and teaching younger generations the dances. Folk dance is performed in every possible occasion with full of vitality and energy. Folk dance is an exciting way to help students understand different cultures including their own. All in all, dance is something which anyone can do. There is no right way or wrong way to dance. There is just a dance. So come on, let's dance.
But the same journey becomes a beautiful experience when we enjoy the love and support of our dear ones. We, the students of Class 3, present before you endurance in life. Enjoy and be inspired.
A small plant in the forest, looking very happy.
I like the sun. Sun gives me heat and helps me grow.
But when the sun generates more heat, the little plant cries.
Oh, it's too hot. I can't bear this heat. It's burning me.
Slowly, the plant falls down, tired. Next morning, the plant slowly wakes up. It looks up at the sky with a smile, but there is no sun. The plant sees a dark sky.
Oh, it's a cloudy day. I'm happy to see you, cloud. Clouds give me water. I need water to grow.
But when it rains heavily, the poor plant is battered down and submerged in water. A child appears on the stage, looking very happy.
Good morning, Mama.
Go, get ready for school.
Then, in school, she wishes her teacher.
Good morning, Miss.
Good morning.
Go away. You are not my friend anymore.
The little girl sits in a corner. Some negative thoughts enter her mind.
Why are you like this? Your marks are very less. You don't dance or sing well. You have not won any prize.
All your answers are wrong. Your handwriting is horrible. Is there anything inside your head?
You are not my friend. I don't like you. Go away.
Everything in nature, including human beings, is forced to go through various hardships during their lifetime. It is easier to give up, but when we find courage and support, we learn to overcome the hurdles we face.
A woodcutter walks towards the tree.
Oh, you are just the right size. I can cut your branches easily.
No, no, don't cut the tree. It's my friend. Don't worry, my friend. I will be here with you. I will take care of you.
The three negative thoughts continue to haunt her.
Hi, looks like you're very sad. Do you need any help?
Nobody likes me. I don't have any friend.
It's not like that. Our parents love us a lot, but sometimes they are so busy, they forget to show their love. It's the same with our teachers too. And friends, they come and go. Good friends always come back to us.
You are right. Come now, let's help this tree.
The three thoughts haunt her again.
I still feel nobody loves me.
Oh, sweetie, why are you so sad? I had so much work. That's why I couldn't spend time with you. We will work on your grades. I will help you.
When her mother speaks to her kindly, one negative thought vanishes.
What happened? You seem lost? You didn't understand what I taught yesterday? It's all right. I'll help you after class.
The second negative thought vanishes.
Hi, I'm so sorry. I was rude to Esther. I will be your friend. Come on, let's go and play.
The third negative thought also vanishes.
With true love, care, and affection, we can mold our little ones to face the challenges of their life with courage and good spirit.
School life is the best life. Anyone who has been the student knows what school life is.
For the past 2 years, we the students have been undergoing a pandemic situation. But it is true that there is hope which gives us courage and strength to overcome any situation. Even though we couldn't go to school, we continue our studies through online education. Now finally we are ready to go back to school. We the students of class 2 dedicate this dance to each and everyone who has still not lost their faith in hope and are resilient. No matter what, God will raise you up. Thank you.
When I am down and all my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened me, and I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can't stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy sea. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
Celebration. We, the students of Class 7 Standard, are here to perform a contemporary fusion dance theme, We Shall Overcome. Here, we present before you how we have overcome the natural disasters like flood and COVID-19. So sit back and enjoy our mind-blowing performance. Thank you.
Oh,
Success or failure, happiness or sorrow, moments are part of life and vary from person to person. Life is full of unexpected struggles and upheaval. Resilience is the ability to cope up with these struggles. When going through tough times, connecting with friends and families help to ease stress, boost your mind, and makes you happy. Class 9 is presenting a skit of a teen girl who is facing difficulty through her life and hopes to find a ray of hope. She meets with a mighty power which helps her to break the negative chains of life. Let's sit back and enjoy the story, A Ray of Hope.
Thank you.
Resilience is that ineffable quality that allows people to be knocked down by life but still come out stronger than ever. Rather than letting failure overcome them and drain their resolve, they find a way to rise from the ashes. Here comes the students of class 8th and 9th to present a song about resilience. This song is a message to be resilient and to keep trying no matter how many times you fail.
I messed up tonight.